Bruce invited me and Tina over for a double date. I got to Bruce's place before Tina did. When he showed me the doll and said it was his girlfriend, I let him have it. Then he kind of flipped out.
What do you want?
That crazy broad Tina trying to pin this on me? Because she came in screaming, said Tony had been fooling around on her, then she leapt on him like a cat. It was over before it started, and the evidence backs me up.
Yeah, on that subject.
Mr. Carter, you are a big, tough guy, and the smell of garlic pasta coming from the kitchen.
Maybe I got a girlfriend. That's so hard to believe. And Sheila's got nothing to do with this.
Yeah, when you say Sheila,
did Sheila witness the murder of Tony DiNapoli?
I'm done talking. You just need to leave now.
But if she saw something or did something, we understand. You're just trying to protect her because you love her.
It wasn't Sheila's fault, okay? It was mine. Take me. I never should have put her in that situation.
Okay, it's okay. You just
Sheila! Sheila, baby! You can come out! The jig's up.
It's okay.
She's probably too scared.
The information Emerson Codd gave the police led to further investigation of Tony DiNapoli's real murder due to unreal circumstances. Tina Arangino was released. Burly Bruce Carter was detained by local authorities awaiting his trial.
Sheila! I love you!
Burly Bruce?
Aren't you the guy who got me locked up?
The pie maker was surprised that here, perhaps 30 seconds from his own violent death, there were no grand revelations, but rather only one simple thought.
Chuck.
It is you.
But it was the thought that saved his life.
You know, you never told me how you met your girlfriend. Sheila, right?
It's a funny story. We met carpooling. You know, I was tired of being stuck in traffic all the time. Rule is, you need two or more for the diamond lane, so I answered a personal ad in a magazine. Next thing I know, she's at my door. Now, the first few weeks, we commuted together every day. You know, she never said much. Then one night, I'm fixing dinner at my place, and I think, I wonder what she's doing. So I invite her over. What the hell? I did it as a friend, you know? You know how that is.
Yeah.
Something happened at that dinner. I don't know what it was. The magic of romance, right? But there was definitely a spark. We had so much in common. We talked for hours. And one thing led to another. Before you know it, she was basically living with me. I love her so much. That's why I took the fall for her.
I know you love Sheila, Bruce, but maybe this is a chance to move on. Find someone full of life.
Oh, Sheila's my girlfriend. I don't care if they don't parole me for 80 years. I'll find her again.
The truth could knock all it wanted, but Burly Bruce would never open the door. And maybe that was for the best.
I'm sure Sheila will still be there, Bruce, waiting for you.